The Trump administration is revamping the H-1B visa program for highly educated and skilled foreign workers. The application period for the employer-sponsored visas opened last Monday, and by Friday, the 85,000 slots available were gone. This means, as usual, there will be a lottery for the H-1B visas later this year. Joining me from Miami to discuss changes to the program is USA Today immigration reporter Alan Gomez. The H-1B visa, just to put people, kind of give them some perspective, this is something the tech industry has wanted and uses for a long time.
Exactly. Companies like IBM, Microsoft, Google, they've been bringing in these workers for a very long time. What they argue is that there's just not enough American workers that are graduating in the STEM fields, in science, technology, engineering, mathematics, to fill all the jobs that they need. And so they need to bring in these workers from overseas who are specially trained in these fields to augment and to build and to continue increasing their businesses.
But it's been controversial ever since it was introduced. There have been people complaining that this is taking away American jobs.
Yes, it's been incredibly controversial. I mean, we hear all about sort of how undocumented immigrants in the country are taking these lower skilled jobs from American workers, but that argument has absolutely carried over into the high tech field. And the argument is that a lot of these companies, people claim, are firing American workers, American computer programmers, technicians, systems analysts, IT workers, and getting rid of their higher salaries and replacing them with these H-1B workers who can come in and in some cases do the work for cheaper. In some cases, like, for example, last year, Disney World was accused of laying off hundreds of workers and even having them train their Indian replacements to take over their jobs. This is something that's gotten a lot of people very upset and got a lot of traction throughout the Republican presidential campaign last year.
That wasn't the intent of the law as it was designed, so how does the Trump administration plan to fix it?
This is one of the areas that we're not exactly sure where President Trump sits. There are people within his administration. For example, Attorney General Jeff Sessions has been railing against the H-1B program for years. And so we saw just on Monday the Department of Justice issue a notice on that first day of the H-1B applications saying that the Department of Justice was going to increase their audits of American companies and overseas companies that use these H-1B visas to crack down abuse and to make clear that they weren't going to allow just basically entry-level computer programmers to come in through the H-1B program, to really focus the program on what it was intended to do, these very high-skilled, very hard-to-find experts to bring into the United States.
What's the ripple effect if these audits take place or if the process slows down?
What could happen is you got these tech companies. It's already hard to get these. As you mentioned, there's, I think, one out of every three or four applications that are put in actually get granted. So that's already hard to plan for something that you have to put in an application and it takes several months for it to come in. And then if the federal government starts coming in and auditing your requests and the visas that have been granted, that just creates more uncertainty, and as you know very well, businesses need stability. They need some sort of predictability about what their workforce and what their future is going to look like. So that's just going to make it a little bit more difficult for these companies to operate and to plan for expansions, to plan for new programs, things like that.
All right, USA Today immigration reporter Alan Gomez, thanks so much.
Thank you.